So, like, growing up with a NBA, you know what I'm saying, father and things of that nature, and you a hooper yourself, mm-hmm. what did you get drawn to being an athlete because of your dad, or this is something that you found for yourself?
You know, I was born with it. It's so weird because my dad, this is no secret, he wasn't in my life.
Gotcha.
So it wasn't a thing of like, he's taking me to the courts and we're playing ball. It wasn't any of that. My mom was the one who put me in the AAU, who put me in training camps, who did all that. But it was like, I just loved basketball when I came out, she says. And it was just, it felt so natural to me. Like, I still like riding a bike. That's actually how I got this, playing basketball outside. Yeah, just do it too much. But it's just like riding a bike. I actually got injured when I went to play college ball, but I can still pick up a ball now and it just feels very normal to me.
Got you.
Yeah.
So like with that whole experience of, you know, especially unfortunately, a lot of times in African-American mm-hmm. communities and minority communities, a lot of us don't have our fathers.
Yeah.
They're not there. And usually is usually for the most part due to lack of economics or drugs or
right.
jail or something like that. But someone will look at your dad like he's well off
exactly.
and he's not there. Like, how did you make sense of that dynamic and come into, and how do your relationship stand up?
You know, it was like growing up, you have your ups and downs, because it was like I wanted him in my life, but at the same time, I had to get to a point where I had to look out for me more,
gotcha.
You know, and I couldn't keep letting him hurt me by, you know, broken promises and things of that nature. But now at 24, I'm at the age where I'm like, look, I forgive you for all that.
Right.
That was when I was younger. Let's just build now, because, you know, he recently had a stroke. I think it was about a year and a half ago. And I've always been very stubborn. And that was the one time in my life where I was like, let it go.
Gotcha.
Because you don't want someone to pass away, you know, who's blood to you at that. And you didn't get a chance to speak to them or tell them how you felt. So we still don't talk, but I think we'll get to that point.
And I hope y'all do. I mean, because you got a lot of life to live
still,
you know what I'm saying? And actually, like I said before, I'm down here. I came to see my father. Mm-hmm. And my father wasn't really in my life like that. And now he's in hospice dying from brain cancer.
Oh, my gosh.
So I took my son, who's five, mm-hmm. and I went to break. Because I never met my biological grandfather on either side. I didn't have my dad. And so now my son knows his dad. And he knows, at least got to see and say he saw my dad and
right.
talked to my dad.
Wow.
That was more for me to break that curse.
Mm-hmm.
But I look at him and I'm like, man, I feel bad for you. Because here you are in your last days. You had no relationship with none of your kids.
Yeah.
Now, we coming off of the strength of, we wouldn't have this life without you.
Right, exactly.
So we here.
Exactly.
But you could have went out a whole different way, surrounded by a whole bunch more love.
More love, yeah.
Yeah, so definitely,
yeah.
If y'all can, you know what I'm saying, repair that. I know it's tough, but
yeah.
definitely do a lot of life to live.